India is well on its way to become a superpower of the world. A status, currently owned by elite nations like the USA, Russia, and China. In order to do so, India has to think like a superpower and develop technologies comparable to the existing superpowers, in all aspects including defense. The rapid advance of technology is producing rapid changes in the threats India faces. Especially, considering the fact that India has a neighbor like Pakistan. So to keep up, India has to develop advanced fifth-generation technologies capable of protecting a superpower. So, the easiest way to develop technologies of a superpower is to work with a superpower. The success of the Indo-Russian BrahMos missile program motivated both countries to develop a fifth-generation fighter aircraft. And thus, in 2007, the FGFA program was born. The responsibility of turning this project into a reality was given to Hindustan Aeronautics Limited of India and the Sukhoi Corporation of Russia. A fifth-generation fighter jet is an aircraft which possess features like all-aspect stealth, low probability of intercept radar, high-performance airframes, advanced avionics, and highly integrated computer systems, capable of networking with other elements within the battle space for situation awareness. The Indo-Russian FGFA program is based on the Russian Sukhoi PAK FA program. In December 2011, the two nations signed a 50-50 joint venture to build the aircraft. At that time, Russia was already testing a handful of prototypes of the T-50 aircraft under its PAK-FA program. While India, on the other hand, was working on its own advanced multi-role combat aircraft, or the AMCA. In June 2001, India was offered joint development and production of the PAK-FA by Russia. PAK-FA, which means Future Air Complex, or Tactical Air Forces, is intended to be the same size as the USJSF, but have a mission profile closer to the F-22 Raptor, with air superiority being the primary mission, and ground attack and reconnaissance being secondary. The Indian version of the FGFA will be a two-seater aircraft, capable of flying at a speed of 2,600 km per hour, with a climbing speed of 330 meters per second. It will have a maximum flying distance of up to 5,500 kilometers, with a maximum operational endurance of up to 5 to 8 hours. The maximum takeoff weight of the FGFA will be 35.5 tons, while its maximum operational load will be 10 tons. The main features of the FGFA are super maneuverability, low radar cross-section, ability to cruise at supersonic speed without the use of afterburner, virtual co-pilot, short takeoff and landing, in-flight refueling system, L402 Himalayas electronic countermeasures system, and the capability of engaging both airborne and ground targets. The FGFA also packs other gizmos like an internally mounted cannon, OLS 50-meter infrared search and tracking system, and all-moving vertical stabilizer. Powering the aircraft is a first-stage all-aspect vectoring nozzle engine, and a second-stage cruise and reheat engine. But what sets the FGFA apart is the SH-121X band nose-mounted active phased array radar, which has a range of detection up to 400 kilometers, and is capable of tracking up to 60 targets at a time, while simultaneously engaging up to 16 targets. The aircraft measures 5 meter tall, 20 meter long, and 15 meter wide, which leaves enough room to pack Russian K-77 medium-range air-to-air missile, K-37M long-range air-to-air missile, KH-38ME guided short-range air-to-ground missile, KH-58U air-to-ground anti-radar missile, and KAB-500 guided bomb. Till now, the conceptual design stage was completed, at a cost of $295 million, after considering more than 40 modifications proposed by the Indian Air Force. The completed FGFA will include a total of 43 improvements over the T-50, including stealth, super cruise, advanced sensors, networking and combat avionics. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do check out our other videos as well. Links to a few are on your screen. Please subscribe and do not forget to hit the like button. See you in another video. Thanks for watching.